This man, he's played 17 games in his first year. He was pick number 41. He plays for the Saints. His name's Jack Loney. Welcome to Future Stars.
Yeah, thanks, guys. Thanks for having me.
I know the Saints are down the bottom end of the ladder, but it is a big effort to play 17 games in your first year. How have you found it?
No, it's been fantastic. I've been lucky enough to be surrounded by pretty good people at the Saints, and yeah, it's been along for the ride, and I just really wanted to play as many games as possible, and yeah, I was lucky enough to play 17 and was very happy with my year.
Just having a look at some of your highlights, and I first saw you down in Morwell play your first practice game against the Bombers, but what I noticed even that day and throughout the year was just your intensity around the ball and your intent on using your speed. You knew how good you were with your speed and your evasiveness, and you've used it all year against players who have played 100, 200 games.
Yeah, I suppose you've just got to stick to what you're good at and try and keep up with what's going well, and I've really worked hard on improving my pace. I probably wasn't my my strongest point last year, and I felt like I improved it this year, and yeah, still got a lot of improvement to go.
Jack, it looks like a great place to be at the moment. Got a lot of young players sort of coming through all at the same time. Jack Billings is a player that I really like. I know he's been injured a little bit this year, but it looks like he's going to be a really good player for the footy club.
Yeah, Jack's fantastic. I've watched him a lot last year, and especially this year in pre-season, and love the way you go about it. He's a beautiful left foot kick, and someone I look up to, and hopefully I can be as good a player as he is.
Now, Jack, your cousins Ryan and Nathan obviously played a lot of AFL footy. How close are you with them, and how much of an influence did they have on your career early days?
Yeah, I speak to Ryan and Nathan pretty regularly. They look after me. They don't really offer me much advice. They just think they always say that I'm always better than them already. So I've still got a bit of work to do. They played 100 games each, and yeah, both very good players, and yeah, I look up to them a lot.
Where'd you get your pace from? Because they were pretty slow.
Yeah, I suppose my dad's pretty quick, and he's pretty short. That's where I get my height from. So yeah, I'll say my dad.
Now, Jack, we're to pick up on your draft day last year. Your boy from Seaford, just around the corner from the Saints. What was your expectation on the night as you sat down to watch it?
Yeah, I suppose I was happy with my TAC Cup year, and I thought if I was good enough, I'd get there. And it was a pretty nervous night. I wasn't 100% sure if I was going to go or not. And when my name got read out at pick 41, I was ecstatic, and with my family and friends, and it was a great night.
I think you might have snuck your way down to the training venue, did you, that night to take a couple of pictures?
Yeah, I did. Me, my brothers and my sister went down to Linen House and took a photo out the front, and yeah, it was pretty special.
One thing I noticed during your under 18 year, you actually got sat on quite a bit. You know, you're that type of player that is very, very dangerous. Do you think that helped? I mean, a lot of the midfielders just freelance their way through the under 18s. The fact that you had actually had some strong defensive tags, do you think that helped you stepping up?
Yeah, certainly. I think that made me a lot better player. It definitely made me work harder. Yeah, worked harder to get your kicks, and yeah, it just makes it that much better. And I suppose that's football, and at the times everyone's trying to get drafted and things like that, but yeah, I just put my foot down and try to work as hard as possible.
Yeah, when I knew you were coming on, I rang your skipper Rui just to ask a few things about you, and he seems to think you were a father-son combination under Adam Schneider. So tell us about that.
Yeah, I suppose me and Schneider got paired up pretty early. We had a trip to New Zealand in the pre-season about week one of being drafted, and I roomed with him, and he's a fantastic footy person. He has a great brain, and I've just tried to pick it apart as much as possible this year, and I've probably hang around him like a bit of a bad smell, but yeah, disappointing to see him retire, but I'll stay close with Schneider forever.
So, Jack, what would be the message then for the smaller guys that are out there? To be many like you at about the 174 centimetre mark. What's your message to those who are trying to get into the AFL?
I suppose you've just got to be elite at all facets of your game. Your skills must be perfect, and you must make the most of the opportunities, and being a small forward, you've got to put pressure on, and just be evasive, be up and about. Really, I like the energy that Hayden Ballantyne brings to Fremantle. I watched him a lot last year, and just the way he goes about, he's always nipping around and being annoying, and yeah, I've loved the way he plays.
Yeah, not too sure about the forward pressure. I didn't put a hell of a lot on when I played, but you've been great to watch so far this year. Have a great off-season, and good luck next year when you get back to the Saints playing AFL footy.